Imagine you had a friend named Matthew who started a fishing business last summer. He was complaining that some days he made a boatload of money, while others he barely earned enough to drive back home. Wanting to help him out, you looked over both his fishing ledger and log of historical data, trying to figure out if there was any pattern. You noticed he goes out and fishes for about 2 to 3 hours at a time, 3 days a week, and has recorded tons of data from those days. You started doing a deep dive into that data, seeing if there were any insights you could gain. You started plotting fish caught by time of day, weather, and even how long he was out for. Through all of your analyses, nothing showed any sort of relationship, until you stumbled upon a revelation. The hotter the day, the more fish he seemed to catch. Looking to visualize this relationship, you started plotting the amount of fish versus the temperature, with the temperature on the x-axis and fish caught on the y-axis. After plotting the data, you saw a positive linear relationship on the scatter plot, appearing to show that as temperature increased, so did the number of fish caught. After explaining this to him, you suggested he focus on fishing only during the hottest days of the week. And about a month later, he called you up and claimed his profits had doubled. So why did his profits double? Was it just luck, or is there something else going on? This story is actually the perfect example of linear regression, which is a statistical method for finding a relationship between two variables in order to predict an outcome that can be modeled with a linear straight line. To do so, let's take another look at the scatter plot you built. The temperature at the bottom is our independent or predictor variable, the thing we are using to help us make a prediction. The fish caught is our dependent or response variable and depends directly on the average temperature that day. Now, even though we saw a positive linear relationship, we could have as easily seen a negative one or even a non-linear relationship as well. Identifying the trend of the data helps us determine what sort of action we should take. In this case, we will need to use linear regression for a linear relationship. Once you finish making your scatter plot, the next step is to plot a line of best fit. This is the regression line, which shows the relationship of your data and helps us make predictions. Since this is a linear relationship, the equation of the line is just the familiar y equals mx plus b. M here is the slope and tells us how our graph changes as temperature increases. For example, if m equals 2, then for every 1 degree increase in temperature, Matthew could expect to catch on average 2 additional fish, and is the quantifiable relationship we are looking for. B is the y-intercept, or our baseline. This helps tell us how many fish we can expect if the temperature was 0 degrees. Now, if we did look at 0 degrees, we might get negative fish, but that doesn't make sense in our case. This is because we should not extrapolate too far outside the data we actually have, as our model is likely only good enough for the data Matthew has actually collected. Extrapolating too far out when the water is frozen or boiled will give us erroneous values. Now that we can interpret our line of best fit, let's actually plot it. You'll notice if we try to plot it, there are a few different ways we can fit the line. Different lines of best fit will give us different predictions, so it is important we choose a good one. A few different ways we can do this is starting at the first point and ending at the last point, or we can try to put it in the middle of our data. Unfortunately, even with a good positive linear relationship, there is still going to be uncertainty in what we predict. There are many ways and theories on how to best plot our line of best fit to reduce these uncertainties, but one of the most common is the least squares method, or ordinary least squares for linear regression. Simply put, the distance from our line to each point is known as an error term, or residual. The higher the error term, the farther away our data is from our prediction. Ideally, we want as small an error term as possible, because this will improve our predicting ability. The least squares method takes a look at the square distance of each residual from our line and minimizes it. Think about moving the line up or down, or adjusting the slope so each error line is as small as possible. We'll then square those distances because we'll treat the positive and negative values the same, and larger errors counting much more than smaller ones. For example, a squared value of 2 is only 4, but a squared value of negative 4 is 16 and penalized much more. So there we have it. We have our error minimized line from the OLS method, or the ordinary least squares method. But how useful is it? Well, we need to know how well it actually helps us predict the number of fish Matthew can expect. There are a few statistical methods we can use to see how well it will predict our data. One of them, the perhaps the most common and well-known, is the R-squared one. It ranges from 0 to 1 and tells us how much of the data is described by our model. For example, let's say we found our model has an R-squared value of 0.85. This means that our model is a good choice and a very strong fit, with 85% of the variation in fish caught explained by temperature. Now that we know our line is strong, with an R-squared value of 0.85, we need to make sure it is also valid and appropriate. Simple linear regression does have a few necessary mathematical assumptions, and one of the best ways to confirm them is to look at the residuals. We can actually plot these on a residual plot in order to determine if our line of best fit is actually good for predicting our values. Simply put, a residual plot should look like a sea of random dots with no clear pattern. Statisticians refer to this property as homoscedasticity. If there is a pattern like a cone shape or a U-shape, then your model likely missed something and your line of best fit is not very accurate. This could indicate you need to perform a different kind of regression or the variable you chose was not the best to predict the number of fish caught. Here it looks like a residual plot is good, and so we can accept our line of best fit. It is also important to note you would want to check that the residuals are independent of each other and normally distributed. You could verify these with a QQ plot and want to see that the residuals are linear on it, and we'll assume they are in this case. So after building, testing, and verifying our model, let's finally make a prediction. The forecast says that tomorrow has an average temperature of 27 degrees Celsius, or about 80 degrees Fahrenheit. From our graph, we can then find the Y values associated with the temperatures to be 30 fish, which is how much we can expect to find. You can relay this information back to Matthew, and now he knows, before he even wakes up, how many fish he can expect to catch tomorrow. While we noticed a positive linear relationship for temperature, life is usually not so simple, and multiple variables may be needed to explain the full story. If we were to add another variable, such as weather or temperature by time of day, this simple linear regression turns into a multiple regression, and can help them refine the fishing strategy even more. This can also help account for other scenarios, like if it is hot but cloudy or cold but humid. It is also crucial to realize that just because temperature is positively correlated with more fish, this doesn't implicitly mean higher temperatures cause more fish to appear. There could be another variable, like less people out fishing during hotter days, leaving more fish to be caught. It is the same reason that ice cream sales are positively correlated with drowning, because people eat ice cream more during the summers and also swim more during the summers. It does not mean ice cream causes drownings, and it also implies correlation does not equal causation. So why do we care? Well, while it is useful for catching fish in our scenario, regression analysis is actually used everywhere. It is an extremely powerful way to help predict the future and optimize strategies through statistical modeling. It has applications in machine learning, advertising, and even analytics. For example, someone who buys a video game is probably more likely to purchase something related to gaming versus someone who has never purchased a game in their life. Another example is that someone who watches a linear regression video would be more likely to be interested in logistic regression. Speaking of recommending videos, if you found this one helpful, make sure to check out my other videos. You'll probably also like them. Like and subscribe for more.